going to discuss in this screencast how the fugacity of each component in a binary mixture changes if we start with a liquid and then raise the temperature. So we have vapor liquid mixture, and we raise it further till we have all vapor. And what we're interested in is how the fugacity of each of the components change. So let's first look at a diagram. So on the left, we have a TXY diagram. On the right, we have fugacity as a function of temperature. So let's first look at the TXY diagram. We're going to start with a mole fraction of 0.4, this point here. And the idea is we're going to raise the temperature. This TXY diagram is generated from Raoult's law. And there's a one-line simulation that will show you this diagram and some other related aspects of Raoult's law. What we're going to do is raise the temperature until we get to this point, the bubble point. Then, of course, the vapor, this is Y of benzene. This corresponds to temperature versus mole fraction of liquid phase of benzene. As we continue to raise the temperature, the vapor is enriched in benzene. What's going to happen is the mole fraction of benzene is decreasing. So as we raise the temperature, the mole fraction of benzene in the two-phase region goes down, which means the mole fraction of toluene is going up. Likewise, the mole fraction in the vapor phase in equilibrium, these values here, are decreasing for benzene, and therefore they must be increasing for toluene. And this happens until we get to the dew point. Now the mole fraction is significantly lower than 0.4 for benzene. And once we get in the vapor phase, of course, now we have a mole fraction of 0.4 again for benzene and 0.6 for toluene. So the question is, as we raise the temperature like this in a system that's at constant pressure, this is an important aspect that we're doing this at constant pressure. The plots on the left, this is the fugacity of benzene, and this is the fugacity of toluene. This region here, liquid phase, region here, vapor liquid equilibrium, and then here is vapor phase. So as we raise the temperature, we're raising the saturation pressure exponentially, and the mole fraction XB is constant for the liquid, but the saturation pressure is increasing exponentially, and so fugacity is increasing significantly. Likewise, the mole fraction of toluene is constant, but its saturation pressure is increasing. So up to the bubble point, both of these are increasing with temperature. We'll look at the two-phase region last. Let's look at the vapor phase region. Well, here is the fugacity of benzene. It's now equal to the mole fraction of benzene in the vapor phase times the pressure. So this is 0.4 times pressure. And fugacity of toluene, again, its mole fraction times the total pressure. And this is 0.6. So, of course, the fugacity is higher for toluene in the vapor phaser. The two-phase region is a little more complicated, so let's look at that on a fresh diagram to make it a little easier to see. So in the two-phase region, remember, as we raise the temperature, the mole fraction of benzene is decreasing in the liquid phase, and therefore the mole fraction of toluene is increasing. So benzene in liquid phase and benzene in vapor phase have the same fugacity. So we can look at this in a couple ways, but if we look at, and let's refresh our memory here, this is fugacity of benzene, this is fugacity of toluene. In this region, so we continue to increase the temperature, we're increasing the saturation pressure of toluene. We're also increasing the mole fraction of toluene. So in the liquid phase, remember, we're moving this way. And the benzene mole fraction is going down, so the toluene mole fraction is going up, which means the fugacity is increasing for toluene in this region. For benzene, if we look at the same way with fugacity, well, the mole fraction, so we could say the fugacity here for benzene is the mole fraction of benzene times the saturation pressure of benzene. The saturation pressure goes up as we raise temperature, but the mole fraction goes down. So it's not obvious from looking at the liquid phase, but remember the fugacity in the liquid phase is identical to the fugacity in the gas phase for benzene when we are in vapor liquid equilibrium. And so the fugacity of benzene in the gas phase is the mole fraction times the total pressure. Total pressure is constant. The mole fraction of benzene, remember we're moving, here's the mole fraction benzene in the vapor phase at the bubble point, and it's continued to decrease as we raise the temperature, and so therefore the fugacity of benzene is decreasing as we raise the temperature. And so I've included a figure at a different mole fraction, the TXY diagram. Let's suppose we start at 0.6. Here's the corresponding plots of fugacity of each of the components versus temperature, and it would be good practice for you on your own to make sure you can, one, identify which is benzene and which is toluene, and also explain the behavior in each of the curves.